The most annoying part about getting web hosting is the fact that if you want to get a good price, you have to buy for like 3 or 4 years in advance and prepay for all of it. And if you want to cancel, well, you only got like 30 days for that. So it's easy to get stuck with an expensive, bad deal. So services like Cloudways claim to offer an alternative to the standard shared web hosting packages on the market. Managed cloud hosting with flexible monthly pricing that you can cancel at any time. In fact, they're so confident it's a great service that they even offer a 3-day trial with no credit card needed. You could use the link in the description right now to transfer a copy of your website to Cloudways, set it all up, and just test it out if it works for you or not. But why would you need to test it out? Well, because technically Cloudways isn't even a hosting provider. It's more of a reseller renting out cloud servers they buy from other providers and attaching their proprietary control panel so that you don't have to worry about complicated server management. So in essence, the real product you're buying from Cloudways is the control panel, because you can get servers from the providers directly at 2 times lower cost. Why is that even important though? Well, currently the 2 most popular types of web hosting services are virtual private servers, VPS, where you just buy the server, connect to it using the IP address provided, and every command you need to issue to the server is just written as code through the terminal. It's cheap, very flexible, very scalable, yet hard to use. And then there are shared hosting services like Hostinger or A2 Hosting that have servers they're managing and configuring themselves, not really giving you admin controls over it. So you can't choose what type of software the server uses, you can't scale it up or down, you can't change the operating system. Basically, it comes prepackaged and you have to use it as is. Cloudways combines these 2 types into managed cloud hosting. They're using a VPS-like configuration on the server side paired with a flexible control panel for the interface. This way, you keep both the flexibility and scalability of the server and the ease of use and speed of a managed interface. So does this unique blend offer the best of both worlds or the worst of both worlds? For the servers, there are currently 5 providers to choose from, with maybe more added in the future. But for now, there's DigitalOcean, Vulture, Linode, AWS, or Google. They all vary in price and performance, but I tend to mostly use DigitalOcean or Linode because both are a great mix of price to performance ratio, so I recommend you start there as well if you do go with Cloudways. To give you a baseline of what you can expect, I've created this demo website on the 1 GB DigitalOcean configuration and ran several speed tests, and it averaged out at around 1.5 seconds total load time, with the server responding within 100 milliseconds. Now, I can't give you an accurate speed test for Cloudways because every Cloudways server comes from a different source and at a different power level. But since even the cheapest one was acceptable in terms of performance, I wouldn't worry about it that if you're going with Cloudways. But since it's my job to worry about web hosts, I did some more testing, just to be sure. I've added Cloudways to my public test website called uptime.emitreviews.com, where I send a bot every minute to the website to see how fast the server responds and if the website is still online. While the website was stable and didn't go offline at all, I was a bit worried about the server response time. It went up from 100 milliseconds and averaged out at around 450 milliseconds at around the 2 weeks mark, which wasn't a good result, especially for the price I was paying, because it means my server was dealing with around 0.5 second lag on every action, while a very similarly priced A2 hosting plan offered 4 times better server response time, around 100 milliseconds. I did try to contact the support to poke around this issue to see if maybe I've done something wrong and my website wasn't set up properly, but I didn't get a decent response. They've supposedly done some optimizations that I hadn't done myself, but it didn't improve the situation at all. And that makes sense. Remember the part where Cloudways just sells you servers from other providers? They have no control over how well these servers perform. It's not their servers. They can't do anything about it. Just ask the original provider for answers on your behalf. So even though I was paying $14 a month for this server, it definitely performed like a $6 server. And that's because it is a $6 server if I buy from DigitalOcean directly. I mean, it's not absolutely the worst thing in the universe, but if I wasn't creating this website for a video, but for a real project, I would have switched servers because I try to keep my server response time to a maximum of 300 milliseconds for optimal performance. But there's nothing stopping me from switching servers though. I haven't paid anything to Cloudways yet and they bill based on usage at the end of the month. So since I'm unhappy with this particular server, I just deleted it from my account and that's it. I'll pay like 10 cents at the end of the month for this. Then I can start up a new server that's a bit more powerful, load up my backup in like 2 minutes and boom, a brand new server. I've gone for the 2 GB option this time, both my TTFB and load times improved to where I would like for them to be at this price point. And that's the real value of Cloudways. It's fast to use. In just a few clicks, you can choose between your website creation tools, such as WordPress for generally any site, WordPress plus WooCommerce for online shops, and plenty of other content management systems like Magento. And you're not limited to just WordPress. Of course, you can even use your server to create web apps as well. Then you switch between server management and application management using this little toggle and tweak the settings around the way you want. Of course, while the default settings work, advanced users will get much more out of Cloudways by enabling or disabling specific settings they need for their specific project. And if you have no idea how much resources your website needs, or it varies on like a day-to-day or a week-to-week basis, well, Cloudways even thought of that with their autonomous plans where they react to the server load and scale up or scale down as much as needed for optimal performance. You get billed based on usage and pay at the end of each month. In short, and in my opinion, Cloudways sells freedom. The freedom to sign up and test for free, the freedom to pay monthly, the freedom to leave at any point and take your site with you, the freedom to switch to another server at any point or scale your resources up and down on demand. So, who should use Cloudways? One, well, obviously, if you don't like the idea of upfront payments, Cloudways is great. They offer the simplicity of something like Hostinger without any commitment. Two, if you often find yourself remaking projects, you'll be able to pause your payments by deleting the server and just spin up a new one when you're ready to start something new. And three, while Cloudways fits any size project, from the smallest hobby site to the largest enterprise solutions, I wouldn't recommend it if you're starting out with a hobby site. Even the cheapest servers are a bit too expensive at around $10 to $12 a month. You don't get email services included for free. You don't get a domain for free as well. So something like Hostinger, E2 Hosting, InterServer, or HemiCloud all come with absolutely everything you need to get started for a much lower price. Even if you have to commit 3 or 4 years in advance, it'll cost you the same as half a year on Cloudways. You can find discount links for all providers mentioned in the description. I hope you found this video helpful and good luck creating your websites.